The objective is to find the components of a vector given its magnitude and direction. In physics and engineering problems, a vector can be a field, a force, a velocity, and so on. Now let's start with a very simple example shown on the right. This is a force of 20 newtons applied in the positive x direction. So let's call it F. F is equal to a component along x, so 20 with a plus because it's along the positive direction, times the unit vector I, which is the unit vector along x, plus 0 times j, the 0 because there is no component along the y-axis. And in component term, it can be written as 20, 0. In example number 2, we have an electric field E, for example, directed along the positive y-axis. So, E as a vector can be written as 0i, because there is no component along the x-axis, plus 10j. J is the unit vector along y. Now, E is directed along the positive y, and that's why we put plus here. In example number 3, we have a vector of magnitude 40 directed along the x negative. Therefore, V is written as minus 40i, because it's directed along the negative x, plus 0j. There is no component along the y-axis, and V equal in component form minus 40 and 0. This is example number 4. We have a force F that makes an angle theta with the x-axis. And we need to find the components along the x and the y. To do this, we draw a right triangle. Made up of two vectors, fx and fy, so that we can say, or we can write, that our vector f, or force f, equal to fx plus fy. Now, using magnitude and the right triangle and basic trigonometry, we can write that fx, the magnitude of fx, is equal to the magnitude of f cosine theta, because remember fx is adjacent to theta. Now we can say that fy, the magnitude of fy, is equal to the magnitude of f sine theta, it's the opposite side. Now we go back to the vector form, so F will be equal to F cosine theta, the magnitude along x, times I to have a vector, minus magnitude of F sine theta, and j the unit vector. Now, the minus is due to the fact that Fy, the vector Fy, is directed along the negative y direction. In component form, F can be written as F magnitude of F cosine theta, comma magnitude of F sine theta, with the minus here. And since the magnitude of F is equal to 5, the final form of the vector F will be 5 cosine theta, negative 5 sine theta. In example number 5, we are given vector V that makes an angle of 140 degrees with the positive x-axis, and its magnitude is 10. Now we need to select a triangle, a right triangle, to calculate the magnitude of the components of V along the x and the y axis. Now, the vector that we, the right triangle that we are going to choose is this one here. We will have Vx and Vy. So this is our right triangle. Vx and Vy are vectors. And therefore, we can write our vector V as being equal to Vx plus Vy. Remember, the directions of Vx and Vy are such that they respect the rule of addition of vectors, meaning that the finishing point of Vx must coincide with the starting point of Vy. We now need to find an angle inside the right triangle. Let's take this one here, call it theta dash. Theta dash is equal to 180 minus 140 degrees, which gives 40 degrees. Now we now use the right triangle and the magnitude of V, Vx and Vy and basic trigonometry to write Vx, magnitude of Vx is equal to the magnitude of V cosine 40 degrees. The magnitude of Vy is equal to the magnitude of V sine 40 degrees. We now write V in vector form as V cosine 40, the magnitude of Vx, I the unit vector, and we need a minus here because Vx is in the negative direction, plus Vy is in the positive direction, so we put a plus, magnitude V sine 40 degrees and the unit vector Gj. In component form, V equal minus the magnitude of V, which is 10 cosine 40, comma, the magnitude of V, it's 10 sine 40 degrees. Example number 6, we are given a vector of magnitude 20 and an angle of 122, the positive x-axis. So the first thing we need to do is to write to find the right triangle so that we can write the addition of V as the component along x and the component along y. So this is going to be Vx. And this is going to be the component Vy. And we can write V equal Vx plus Vy. Remember, Vx plus Vy, it's a vector addition. And therefore, the finishing point of Vx must coincide with the starting point of Vy. Now we need to find the angle, inside the right triangle. So let's consider this angle here, theta dash. Theta dash is equal to 180 minus 122 degrees, which gives 58 degrees. We now use the magnitude of V, Vx, Vy, the right triangle and some basic trigonometry to write that the magnitude of Vx, which is adjacent to theta dash, it's equal to the magnitude of V cosine 58 degrees. Vy, which is opposite to theta dash, it's equal to the magnitude of V sine 58 degrees. In vector form, V is equal to Vx is in the negative direction, so it's minus magnitude of V cosine 58 degrees and the unit vector. Along the y-axis, it's going in the negative direction, so again, there is a minus magnitude of V sine 58 degrees. In component form, and using the magnitude of 20, so it's negative 20 cosine 58 degrees, comma, minus 20 sine 58 degrees.